Inna a'tainaka al-kawthar. We've given you the greatest, the most abundant good.
The Prophet ﷺ said that when Allah created the creation, family stood up. How did family stand up? We don't understand. Allah knows how. The concept of your family stood up, however that was, we don't understand. In Arabic, it's ar-rahim. That's the ties of kinship, the ties of the womb. Ar-rahim, it stood up. And it said, now is the time to seek from you what I need. هَذَا مَقَامُ الْعَائِذِ مِنْكَ I'm seeking your protection now, before you send me to this world. As soon as Allah created the creation, somehow, we'll never understand how, family stood up. And family said, before you send me to this earth, I need to ask you one thing. So Allah said, what do you want? Are you not happy that I will have a relationship with anyone that has a relationship with you? And I will cut off from any who cuts off from you. So Allah is asking a rhetorical question, what more do you want? I've given you all of this. And so the family was satisfied. Ar-Rahim was satisfied. In another hadith Qudsi, the Prophet ﷺ said that Allah has said, Ana Ar-Rahman, I am Ar-Rahman. And from my name Ar-Rahman, I created the family, Ar-Rahim. Ar-Rahim in Arabic is the ties of kinship. Allah is saying the concept of the family, somehow we don't know how, we leave it to Allah, the details. But what do we need to get from this? The concept of family has been created from Ar-Rahman's name. When we examine our family relationships, every family has its politics. Wallahi, we think that maybe only our family has such bad politics or this and that. No, this is the reality. Every single family has its politics. Every family has people who do this, who do that. And by the way, me and you are no angels either. Let's be real here. If they do something, yes, we will also do something. If they say something, we will also say something. This is the reality of families. There's a beautiful story. One of the sons of Hassan had an argument with one of the sons of Hussein. They're both great grandsons of the Prophet ﷺ, the Ahl al-Bayt, they're cousins. And it became a big argument, and it took place in public over a very big issue. And they parted in an angry way. This one of the cousins went home, and he could not sleep that night. And late at night, he left his house and he went knocking on his cousin's door. And he opened the door in the middle of the night. What do you want? Everything all right? You're coming in the middle of the night. You know what this great grandson of the Prophet ﷺ said? He said, Yabna Am, oh my cousin, can't we remain brothers even if we disagree? Just because we had a fight, can't we still be brothers in Islam? Okay, we don't agree about everything, but still, can't we remain brothers for the sake of Islam? And when he said this, his cousin's heart melted and they hugged each other and they made up from each other. This is the reality of families. It's give and take. One Sahabi came to the Prophet and said, O Messenger of Allah, my family, I have some family members. I'm good to them, they're rude to me. I gift them, they curse me. I'm always doing this, they're doing that. And the Prophet ﷺ said, if what you say is true, then it is as if you are sending hot wind in their direction. You're irritating them, and Allah Azza wa Jal has sent an angel to protect you from what they're trying to give back to you. I.e., the gist of it is, you have the upper hand. And what you're doing, Allah will protect you, and your actions are harming them rather than their actions harming you. And our Prophet ﷺ said, مَنْ أَحَبَّ أَنْ يُنْسَأَ لَهُ فِي عُمُرِهِ Whoever wishes that his life be prolonged, وَيُبْسَطَ لَهُ فِي رِزْقِهِ And that his money be increased, فَلْيَصِلْ رَحِمَهُ Let him be good to his family. The Prophet ﷺ promised us the two most precious things that every one of us, including myself, is greedy for. Wallahi, what are we greedy for? We want to live a long life and we want a lot of money. And in another hadith, in a similar vein, the Prophet ﷺ said, I know of nothing that causes a man's wealth to increase more than being good to his family. And in a third hadith, the Prophet ﷺ said, he who is good to his family shall never be poor. Every one of us, we have our politics with our family. But always be the one on the upper hand. Always be the one whom the Sahabi said, they do this to me, but I am the better of the two. And no doubt, perhaps some of them you will take longer to reconcile with. This is a sunnah of Allah. But the niyyah should be there. That, Bismillah, I'll make a little bit of an attempt. I'll send a little gift. I'll smile. I'll be polite. Maybe they'll be harsh. Maybe they'll send a curse. Control your tongue. And if you don't do it because of them, do it for Allah. Do it for Allah and do it for your own money and your own life.